Conor Oberst is our guest today on the cafe. He leads the band Bright Eyes, who you may have been reading about lately, as there has been an unprecedented media campaign surrounding the release of Bright Eyes' two new discs, I'm Wide Awake, It's Morning, and Digital Ash in a Digital Urn. Conor started making music in his hometown of Omaha, Nebraska in his teens, and almost everything he's ever written has been released. He has built an extensive following for his emotional and honest portrayals of, well, Conor's life. He was also the lone representative of his generation on the Vote for Change tour this past fall. A lot of the new albums, particularly I'm Wide Awake, It's Morning, have songs about New York City, where Conor moved recently, and I asked him how that move from Omaha to New York City happened.
I've been there a lot on tour and just passing through. I mean, I guess starting from when I was 15 or so, traveling with my old band and played there a lot and, you know, made lots of friends and started, I guess, going out and staying at one of my friend's place for like a couple months at a time. Really enjoyed it and felt like it was time to, I guess, get out of Omaha for a while and experience a different, I really like the city because it's, I feel, I guess, at peace there.
With the high energy.
Yeah, yeah.
It's more running at your speed.
Yeah, I suppose so. Or I think sometimes the peace and quiet in Nebraska makes me feel more restless.
Right, I can see that. But you and Mike went back home to record, right? I
mean, yeah. Mike still lives in, actually in Lincoln, Nebraska, and that's where his studio is. And so we do all the recordings there.
What do you want to start off with?
It's called We Are Nowhere and It's Now. And it goes like this.
We Are Nowhere and It's Now. That's Conor Oberst playing live for us today on the World Cafe. You still have the silver reed? he's not saying. I sort of say that because one of the things that I think is great about what you do is how you can universalize these incredibly personal moments that, and everybody I talk to about your music, they say pretty much the same thing. It's one of the things I love about your lyrics, about how you say, stay so, you know, clear to a moment. Are songs from a moment? I mean, is that from a moment and then you run and write things down?
It's not quite that clear cut, I guess. I mean, obviously try to stay aware and open, keep my eyes and my ears open. Just take things in. Eventually they kind of stir around and change shapes and then come back out through a song. And sometimes it's, I guess, more, as you would say, true to a specific moment. And other times it's more of the feeling, I guess.
Do you ever worry, this is something I would worry about if I were in your position, of losing the openness, losing having your receptors out there?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's hard. I mean, I think, you know, for me and for probably everyone in the world, you know, to keep from putting up those walls all the time, because it's a lot easier to live if you have some armor on. But
right.
I think that it's also, there's a lot to experience, so.
As more and more people are asking you questions daily, does it become harder to keep open?
Yeah, I think it is. You know, it's a strange time right now.
Absolutely. Are you still keeping writing? Are you always writing if you're out on tour? Do you write? Are you the kind of person who has to go?
No, I can write wherever. Actually, I can write fairly easily on tour. I mean, it doesn't matter. It's like if it's going to happen, it'll happen wherever I'm at. But it doesn't necessarily always happen or anything. So.
Which is kind of my way of leading to, gee, do you have any new songs? Because I heard you've been doing some new ones.
Yeah.
As you go around.
Yeah. Should we do the I Must Belong Somewhere?
Yes.
Okay. This one's called I Must Belong Somewhere.
That's a new song from Conor Oberst called I Must Belong Somewhere, featuring Macaws and Cauliflowers. A great, great list song. Wonderful. That's a great, great song.
Thanks.
Now, how new is that?
Oh, like a couple weeks.
I
still don't know how it ends.
I made a request for a song I just absolutely love on here, okay, which is the Landlocked Blues, which is another one that Amy Lou sings on the record. Mm-hmm. But can you do that one?
Sure.
Thanks for doing that one. That's Landlocked Blues. Conor Oberst is our guest, Bright Eyes here. And Conor, we haven't mentioned this yet. Conor started all playing music long, long time ago. When you listen back to your first recordings on your own, or even the Commander Venus stuff. How do you feel about it? Are you happy that more people are finding out about you now, or how do you feel?
Well, you know, it's always a little embarrassing and somewhat, you know, it's like looking at an old picture of yourself. It's,
yeah,
it doesn't really look like you, but it kind of does, or you can kind of remember where. I guess it's strange because pretty much almost all every song I've written has been released in some way, you know, whether it's cassette tape or
right.
7 inches or whatever. So I think I don't know, for whatever it's worth, it's like you can kind of see how it...
You can see the progression. Do you see it as a progression? Are you happy with what you're writing now?
Yeah. I mean, I feel like I've been getting more comfortable, I guess, with myself, my voice, and figuring out, you know, it's all kind of trial and error, really.
Right. You're doing something that in today's music world is kind of brave. You kind of have a no clear channel policy, because clear channel being everywhere, it means radio and it means venues too.
Mm-hmm.
How has that worked out venue-wise? Has it been any kind of a problem?
Yeah, I mean, it's really more of a problem for our booking agent. He's the one that has to deal with it and find alternative promoters, and it makes it more difficult. But I think it's worth it. You know, it's just dangerous to just give in completely to... complete control of a entire industry and all the information being given to the American people. They promote mediocrity in every way.
Has it caused you to be booked into some pretty interesting places?
Well, we're playing a beautiful place tonight.
That's true.
Philadelphia.
It hasn't hurt you here in Philadelphia at all. Connor, you mentioned wanting to do something else?
Yep. Again? Yeah. I got this jam. I'm just gonna do that other one. Okay. This is a song called "When the President Talks to God," and it goes like this.
A song that doesn't need you to explain it in any way.
Okay, good.
Connor, thank you so much for coming by. It's a real treat.
Thank you so much.
Connor Oberst, our guest, and we'll be back in a moment here on the World Cafe.